How to find a good ham radio club. I know, many people who watch my channel really aren't interested in ham radio clubs. But hear me out. I think that several things have changed that can make radio clubs viable for a lot of people. And here's how to find your perfect match. And if you don't like clubs, that's fine too. I'll show you the way. So I visit a lot of clubs due to what I do in ARRL and also because I just love ham radio. And here are some things I learned about radio clubs. The first thing is that radio clubs have to match your interests and personality. If your local club exists to support its repeater and you primarily operate HF or a DXer, a contester, or like building your own equipment, then you would probably not fit in well. I learned this early on, and I was in a couple of clubs before I found my fit. But that was after I found what I like in ham radio. And for me, this comes down to three things: DXing, contesting, and building or tinkering with equipment. When I first moved to New Jersey, I notified Steve Mendelson, W2ML, because he was the communications director for the New York City Marathon. He encouraged me to join a local club here. One of them was the DX club called the North Jersey DX Association. I attended a few meetings and I saw a few interesting presentations on DX. The first ones that really made an impact were the presentations about DX expeditions by Marty Lane, OH2BH, and others. If you don't know who Marty is, as I didn't as a beginning DXer, he basically goes all over the world to put rare and new DX entities on the air. At that time, though, he put Scarborough Reef in the South China Sea on the air, and it was very interesting. At that time, I knew I had to get in with this club, and I earned my DXCC because that was a requirement to join, and I became a member of this radio club. Another club I later joined was the Frankfurt Radio Club, which is a contest club. Now, I have a special place in my heart for contest clubs. Why? A lot of contest clubs are actually pretty good, not just with mentoring newcomers, but also with ongoing support and also developing things like hardware and software. Why is that? Well, the purpose of a contest-focused club is to score points and take part in the affiliated club competitions in the various contests. So they are invested in their member success. This means that you will often encounter a very helpful attitude at contest clubs. Yes, you will encounter some alpha hotels. But anyway, just ignore them. You'll find a lot of helpful people who are invested in your success. And in my contest club, we not only provide operating tips, advice, and help for getting your station ready for contesting, but we also help you with actual real-world experience operating the contest. And we also have an awards and recognition program where we not only recognize top scorers, but also most improved. So this boosts team morale and camaraderie. Camaraderie. I won a most improved award one year and it was pretty amazing to do so. One of the other good things about the club is that we don't really have member dues. Instead, we have a voluntary fund drive. Of course, everyone is expected to contribute, but you're not forced into a fixed amount. Clubs do require funds to operate, especially if they run repeaters and the like, or rent a meeting space, or even have a Zoom account for meetings. So I would say, be generous if you can. But if DXing and contesting are not your thing, there are other general interest clubs that do quite well. One trend I've noticed from clubs these days, which is a good thing, is that they're now focusing on guest speakers who can teach you some things. I have seen clubs live or die by this. What do I mean? Well, let's say a club has a meeting once per month. They discuss club business and then proceed to dismiss the meeting, getting nothing else but club business done. Really exciting, right? Not really. Instead, I've seen clubs have people come to their meetings, give talks about various things in amateur radio and otherwise. Remember when I told you about my DX club having people talking about DX adventures? This same concept works. And not only that, you can even stream to YouTube, and if your club is in the partner program, you can make a few extra bucks to support club operations. Yes, I know it's hard to get the 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours, but there are some clubs who can draw a crowd. And one thing I would strongly encourage clubs to do is to have the business meeting entirely separate from the presentations. This way, people who are bored by the business portions won't leave, and leave your guest speaker with a much smaller audience than she or he could have. And today, a lot of clubs can get guest speakers from all over the country or the world because they hold their meetings via video conference or have video conferencing available at their meeting space. I've seen presentations from such prominent ham voices as Tim Duffy, K3LR, and Bob Heil, K9EID. I personally have also spoken at many radio clubs across the United States and even a couple in Canada. I am open to it as my schedule allows, so if you're interested, let me know. Above all, a club should look to make its activities fun and engaging. I know that's becoming more difficult due to the various restrictions we have, but hopefully that can end soon and we can go back to having fun on the radio. But even virtually, you can do things like have virtual kit builds and operate together. And the best part is people who can't leave their home can still take part. But what if you don't like traditional radio clubs? Well, have no fear. There are numerous resources on the internet that you can avail yourself of. One of them is YouTube, of course. And I and other YouTubers have a community of people you can rely on to produce content for you to learn. If there is a topic you want to see, let me know in the comments below. Beyond YouTube, there is Reddit with the subreddit r/amateurradio, which likens itself to a ham radio club and has a lot of people there. There are also Facebook groups, like one of them that I help run, ham radio/new to the hobby, where we provide a friendly atmosphere for new and upcoming hams. Whatever route you take, know that you won't ever go it alone in this hobby. See you next time. As we dance, we got chills.